Hey guys, today I'm going to show you exactly how to find the right anchor text for your website. And I'm also going to teach you exactly how to make sure that you don't get penalized for over-optimizing your anchor text or how to avoid negative SEO attacks with anchor text, right? So if you look at Google's Search Console help and you check out the link schemes page, you know, they have a couple of mentions about anchor text. First of all, they say that you should not do large scale article marketing or guest posting with keyword rich anchor text. So this is something to avoid. So if you're over optimizing on your anchor text, then you could receive a penalty or it could just negatively affect you in the future in terms of your website's rankings, right? And then also, if you're over optimizing your anchor text in, you know, articles, press releases sent on other sites, you know, and Google have a good example here, then, you know, that could be something that gets you penalized as well. So you have to be very careful about the anchor text you choose. And if you're not careful about it, it could land you in a lot of trouble. So this is why I'm creating this tutorial. And if you watch it all the way to the end, you're going to discover exactly how to make sure that you have the best anchor text possible for your website to boost your rankings, to drive more traffic, and to make sure you get the best results with SEO possible. But before you jump in, please make sure you subscribe because my videos are going to help you boost your rankings, drive more traffic, and grow your site with link building. Okay, so the best tool for checking out your anchor text and your overall backlink profile's anchor text is to type in your website on ahrefs.com and then go to anchors, right? And this report is very useful because you can then check, right, is your anchor text over-optimized? What's your backlink profile like? And has your website received any sort of negative SEO attacks? Because, you know, if you're getting unnatural, relevant anchor text to your website, and this is a good example, then it could negatively affect your rankings on Google. So that's something to be aware of. And also, you can see exactly who's linking to your competitors and what anchor text are they using. And that's very useful if you want to reverse engineer your competitors, see how they're ranking on Google, what anchor text are they using to rank first on Google, and how can you beat that? Now, what I will say is that when it comes to anchor text, this isn't a science, okay? It's more of an art, and there's no 100% guarantee when it comes to anchor text. So don't think, right, I have to optimize this to an OCD level. You don't have to get this perfect when it comes to anchor text, but it's very useful for getting a rough picture, a rough estimation of what anchor text you need and how to go about it. So with that, let's jump in. So let me show you an example anchor text profile here. And you can see this is for katsu.com, just picked a random site out of the blue. And as we go through, we can see, right, what's the most common anchor text? And you can see that here, it's listed by the most common. And then how many referring domains are using that anchor text to link to this website. So you can see actually the anchor text here is very varied. And to be honest, when it comes to a natural backlink profile, usually your anchor text is going to be very varied, except that there's going to be a lot of brand name mentions. So you can see this is katsu.com and the most common anchor text is katsu. And that's because that's the website's brand name. So obviously it's going to be used all the time when they're linking to that page. So as we scroll down, you can see this is a very natural backlink profile, and that's what you want to look out for. Now, if you really want to look at your anchor text on a more granular level, you can see here, you can go through these terms at the top. So you can go through one term, so one word anchor text, two word anchor text, three word anchor text, etc. To be honest, that's probably a little bit over the top for most websites. You don't really need to do that unless you're very worried about being hit by a negative SEO attack where people have over-optimized anchor text and built loads of dodgy links to your site with all sorts of dodgy anchor text as well. But on the whole, it's not really necessary. And if we go back to the anchors, you just want to check, right, is the anchor text relevant? Does it look natural? Does it make sense? Is it over-optimized? Right? And if it's not over-optimized, that's okay. If it's natural, that's great, et cetera, et cetera. All right, now sticking to the example of the cat's niche, right? Let's say you have a keyword you want to rank for, just like this, best cat food for kittens. What you want to do is reverse engineer how your competitors are getting links to their site in terms of the anchor text as well, because then you can figure out, right, what's the right anchor text combination to rank for this keyword. Now, as I said again, it's not a science, but it will give you a rough estimate of what you need to aim for, right? So if we go to this keyword, we can see spruce pets are ranking number one. So we can put that into Ahrefs like this. And then once this report loads, we will see a breakdown of the anchor text for that page. And, you know, we can reverse engineer what's working for them. So as you can see, here's some examples of the anchor text that's been used. So you've got like some naked URL text being used there, some anchor text that's very relevant to the keyword, this sort of thing, and also the brand name represents 25% of the anchor text so far. So with this report, you can see, right, what's the anchor text that's being used for this page, because that's what's helping it rank. But also, it's not just the anchor text, it's also the backlinks going to that site. However, this report still helps. And as you can see, it's very varied. So actually, to be honest, apart from the brand name being used so much, most of the anchor text is extremely varied. So they've got 23 different phrases being linked for this content. And then you can say, right, okay, well, actually, if I want to rank for this keyword, then the links that I get added should have a very varied amount of anchor text. I don't need to over-optimize here, and that's working for my main competitor. So it's probably gonna work for me too. Now, going back to this example of best cat food for kittens, what you could do if you really wanna get a varied profile of the anchor text you need to rank for this keyword, you could look at your top three competitors, and then you could combine the anchor text between each one, compare them, and get an overall average of the anchor text you require. So you could put all three websites into ahrefs.com, export the results, and then you'd get more data in terms of what anchor text you need to rank highly for this keyword. So that's it for me and how to reverse engineer your competitor's anchor text to make sure that you can rank higher for a particular keyword. Now, if you want more link building videos on exactly how to grow your website, boost your rankings, and drive more traffic to your site, then please subscribe to my YouTube channel and also check out my playlist on link building and link building outreach, because that will help you drive more backlinks to your website that are going to help you rank, especially my link building and cold email outreach playlist, and also my Hara playlist too. So thanks for watching, guys. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below. And if this video helped you, please smash a like on it. That would mean a lot to me. Thanks.